Ever been sucker punched by your table saw? You might know what I'm talking about. You're happily sawing along when all of a sudden your board flies up and smacks you, or if you luck out, it crashes into the wall instead. Worse yet, perhaps you're carelessly feeding with just your bare hands, and now when the board flies out of the way, you can pull your hand into that spinning blade, which is bad news indeed. What you've just experienced is classic table saw kickback, but you don't have to worry about such a sneak attack because you can protect yourself from it as long as you understand what's going on. The problem with kickback is that it happens so fast that you can't really tell what's caused it. Here's what's going on. As you're feeding a board forward, the downward spinning teeth at the front of the blade are holding the workpiece against the tabletop. So far, so good. It's not until your workpiece reaches the rising rear teeth that the board, if it has veered away from the fence at all, can rub against those rising rear teeth, which catch it and pull it upward on top and across the blade, hurling it backwards at fierce speeds. Now, let's take a close look at how that happens. I'm going to, instead of using this board, I'm going to use a piece of lightweight rigid insulation so that it doesn't hurt my rear wall, and I'm also going to stand to the side out of the way of kickback so I don't hurt myself. Let's take a closer look at that. Now let's look at it in slow motion. Now notice how the panel spins away from the fence as it climbs over the blade. And again, a closer look. And there's the arced scar that tells of the spinning travel over the top of the blade. So how do we prevent kickback? It's really a simple matter of denying those rising rear teeth access to the edge of the board. Now, one of the best tools for the job is a splitter, which is a plate that mounts aft of the blade with the face of the splitter that faces the fence lined up with the sides of the teeth that face the fence. That way, when you're ripping a board, as soon as the edge of the board contacts the splitter, the board can no longer wander over against those rising rear teeth. Problem solved. Let's actually take a cut and see how that happens. So now we understand the importance of preventing a workpiece from drifting over into those rising rear teeth. Now there's no shortage of solutions for that, the best of which is probably a riving knife, which comes incorporated into all modern saws. That really is the best solution. Unfortunately, it's not retrofittable to older saws. However, for older saws, there are a number of aftermarket splitters, such as this Biesmeyer snap-in splitter that we've been using here, which slips into a bracket that you mount onto the rear trunnion of your table saw. Other models as well for various types of saws. Or you can actually mount a splitter onto a zero clearance throat plate. Now here's one example here. This is made by MicroJig. This is a commercial model. And although it's shorter than bigger splitter, it does the job just fine. You can make your own. Here's a wooden splitter that's mounted into the slot on a wooden zero throat plate, just glued in place. And another alternative is you can make a splitter out of aluminum angle, screwing it to the underside of a throat plate. Now, if you don't have a splitter, and I can't stress strong enough that you should have a splitter, but if you don't have one, a feather board is the next best thing. A feather board holds your workpiece against the fence in front of the blade, not behind it, so it's not quite as effective, but it's much better than nothing. So for more on all this, you can check out the article Preventing Kickback in Woodcraft Magazine number 60, which is the August-September 2014 issue. So thanks for watching and stay safe.